Hello, I'm Valder Beebe. I'm the host and a visionary of the Valder Beebe Show's That Celebrity Interview.
Good morning, ladies. I want my audience to know that I have Dr. Jennifer Pate, hope I'm saying that right, and Brandy Bartel in the studios today because they want you to know if a picture tells 1,000 words, then a new Facebook campaign should go a long way in helping to spread the word about a rare but serious liver disease. Ladies, welcome to the Valder Beebe Show.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm glad you're here to talk about LiveHer. And Dr. Jennifer, we're going to start with you, ask you to set the medical platform so my audience can understand.
Sure. What we're talking about today is called PBC. It is short for primary biliary cholangitis. It is an autoimmune disease affecting about 1 in 1,000 women, typically diagnosed between the ages of 30 and 50. Oftentimes, women have no symptoms. Other times, they may have symptoms such as fatigue and itching. It's very important that women have their liver function tests checked at their annual visits so that if this is a diagnosis, they can start treatment earlier and avoid the progression to scarring, cirrhosis, and possibly ultimately needing liver transplant.
Why is it important for women to know about this? Because it sounds very complex, very scientific.
It's important for women to know about this because they could be one of those 1 in 1,000 patients that are impacted. And with the two FDA-approved medications, there are treatments that can keep this under control and will limit the disease progression. And women need to be their own advocates in their health care.
Okay, so how do you know these symptoms, maybe you're having these symptoms, how do you know to bring this up to your doctor? What do you tell your doctor?
To ask your doctor if your liver function tests have been checked, and if they're abnormal, how are they abnormal in terms of which labs are abnormal, and does this need a referral to a liver specialist?
If you don't mind, I'm going to go to Brandy. Brandy, I think you can tell us a little more from an intimate perspective about the disease.
Yeah, so I was initially at a very young age in my 30s, just struggling with extreme fatigue. And I think at that point in my life, I was healthy. And I chalk that up to just chronic stress. I think many of us can relate to that. I fortunately followed up with my primary care physician, which led to discovering I did have those elevated blood liver tests that the doctor referenced earlier. And unfortunately, it was not an easy or quick process to receive that diagnosis of PBC. I actually had to do a lot of follow-up appointments. I had to advocate for my own health. Fortunately, at 34, I did receive the proper diagnosis, which was important because that led to earlier management of the disease, which will hopefully slow down that progression and help me manage it much better.
Can you speak on the LiveHer campaign?
Yes, I am so excited to be a part of this project. First of all, by going on Facebook and searching for the word LiveHer, that's LiveHer, the word combines liver plus her to invoke the fact that this disease affects primarily women. But this project on Facebook just is a beautiful campaign of photography and video that helps to showcase how women like me are able to make the most of our lives despite facing a chronic illness. I was so excited to be a part of this because of the fact that there is a profound need for education and information, things I did not have initially when I was diagnosed. And I hope that all women from learning more can help to prioritize their own liver health by going to their doctor and asking for those routine liver blood work tests at their annual checkups.
Okay. Can you tell me, women, once again, tell me how important it is to us? And I'm asking you because you're walking the walk.
Yes. Well, I will say that, like most women, we have often a lot on our plates. We're managing very busy lifestyles. And I was living a relatively healthy lifestyle. I was eating healthy. I was working out. I didn't abuse drugs or alcohol or over-the-counter prescriptions. And so I felt like liver health was not a significant thing for me to think about, quite frankly, was not top of my mind. But this disease and many liver diseases do affect women. This disease in particular affects mostly women in their 40s and 50s is the average age of when women are first diagnosed. And so it's just so imperative that we consider liver health when going to our doctor. And again, realizing that this is not necessarily something that we have to be depressed about or stop living our lives because of. We can thrive despite the fact that we're facing such a chronic illness.
I'm glad you're a lot better, and thank you for sharing. I really appreciate that. Dr. Jennifer, I'm going to let you wrap up. How can people learn more about this disease and this campaign?
Go to livingwithpbc.com. And also look at support groups such as the PBCers. Also, as Brandy pointed out, the LiveHer PBC campaign. There are lots of valuable resources out there. These patients are not walking this alone.
Ladies, thank you so very much for sharing such an important subject. You've got a great audience. My audience is made up of 89.9% women, and my audience spans more than 13 million, so I know this message is for someone. Thank you.
Thank you so much.